So the first stage here, this was the stage of revelation. Prophet Muhammad was the legist of the Ummah. He is the one who laid down the laws. Of course, it was based on what was revealed to him by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Quran, which was the divine word, direct word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, was combined with the Prophet ﷺ's interpretation in practice of that those divine words, how to implement it. And that constituted really the basic source of law. What the Prophet ﷺ said, what he did, and included in that is what he approved. It wasn't something he did, but his tacit approval, meaning things were done in his presence, and he did not object to them, did not prohibit them, etc. That was sufficient to make it a part of his sunnah. Even though he himself may not have done it, others did it in his presence, and he approved it, then that is sufficient. To have something said that, well, during the time of Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, some people did certain things. Some of the Sahaba did certain things. That's not enough to make it legal, unless it said they did these things and the Prophet ﷺ knew about it and he said nothing. Because simply doing something in the time of the Prophet ﷺ did not, and the Prophet ﷺ didn't rebuke them, did not automatically make that acceptable, unless it was done in his presence. Because the scholars concluded that, of course, Prophet Muhammad ﷺ could not allow anything to be done in his presence which was not acceptable without speaking out against it. He had to. Similarly, anything which he did, which Allah did not want done or did not approve of or whatever, Allah would immediately correct him. Because to leave him uncorrected would be to leave a mistake for the generations to come. So Prophet Muhammad ﷺ was protected from error, meaning that what he conveyed to us was the whole truth, as they say, and nothing but the truth. It was complete.